Well, folks, it's time to kick it old school.
Signatures coming off the bottom of this train that would tell them whether or not these bearings fail. Because when these bearings fail, that is a very serious thing. That's why they have.
It's 12:45.
Detectors. The question is going to be
12:45.
If indeed is the key to this. If those sparks
okay.
come off the bottom of the train and this dramatic slowing down is happening, why would the train not simply stop to address it?
Hey, Tom, I grew up near railroad tracks, and I'm just wondering, some places trains go slower than others because of the areas that they're in, the conditions of the tracks, what have you. Do we know if that is the case? Maybe it's going to go down too early to tell.
We know from federal documents that in that area, the Federal Railroad Authority documents from 2020 would show that the typical speed would have been 40 to 60 miles an hour, not 29 miles per hour. Obviously, if you slow down that much, you're going to know you slowed down that much. Key question, why did you do it? If it wasn't this, what other reason did you?
That answers that. Tom Foreman, thank you very much. I appreciate it. So we're going to be joined by East Palestine residents Jim Stewart and Ben Ratner, who were at the town hall last night. Were they satisfied with the answers from officials and what they want to see happen next? That's in just moments. Plus, Ohio Lieutenant Governor John Husted is going to join us amid the governor's response, so make sure you stay with us.
Also knew overnight the tragedy in Florida, a nine-year-old girl and a television journalist, and three people killed in a series of shootings there. Police say the reporter was actually covering the shooting of a young woman when that reporter was fatally shot.
No one around here, not a mother, not a nine-year-old, certainly not news professionals, should become the victim of gun violence.